Hello and welcome to this video on in-service software upgrade, or ISSU for short. My name is Matt and today I'm going to be showing you this new feature available from Allied Telesis. In this presentation I'm going to be covering what ISSU actually is, how it's been implemented, and then give you a live demonstration with the devices you see in front of me here. So what actually is ISSU? ISSU is a feature that allows you to upgrade the software on a device with no traffic downtime. In other words, traffic keeps forwarding while the controller cards have been upgraded. Behind the scenes, ISSU allows the chassis to run two concurrent software releases at the same time. This is important because the devices need to be resilient and forward traffic correctly while the software version is being internally upgraded. Okay, so what devices can you actually use ISSU on? At this point in time, ISSU is only supported on the CFC960 controller card, which is available in the X8100 series of chassis switches. Now within this range, there are three different supported methods of ISSU. You can do ISSU on a standalone chassis, which has duplex CFCs, so this is where you have dual controller cards. You can do ISSU on VC stack plus duplex, so this is where you have two chassis that are acting as one virtual switch, and both chassis have dual controller cards in them. And you can also do ISSU on VC stack plus simplex. So this is the same as before, but we've only got one CFC in each chassis. Note that with this last method, it is actually known as a rolling update rather than a hitless upgrade. This is because each chassis only has one controller card. And in other words, when you start ISSU, each chassis has to separately reboot during the process. So how does ISSU actually work? When a user initiates ISSU, the system first checks several prerequisites, such as, is ISSU already in progress? Is the new release a compatible build? Once this is done, the new software release is then synced from the active CFC to the standby. The chassis then reboots the standby CFC, which proceeds to boot the new software release. Once the standby CFC has finished booting, it syncs information, such as hardware and software tables, from the active. When syncing has completed, ISSU automatically reboots the active CFC. This causes a CFC failover, with the standby becoming the new active CFC. The old active CFC proceeds to boot the new release and joins the chassis as a standby CFC. The new standby CFC then syncs hardware and software tables from the active. Once the standby CFC syncing is complete, ISSU moves to the CFC's upgraded state. At this point, high availability has been achieved through successfully upgrading both controller cards to the new software version without any chassis downtime. Traffic has continued to flow uninterrupted, no line card ports have gone down, and by definition, the software upgrade has been hitless. Now at this stage, I haven't made any mention of the line cards, or lifts as we call them. The user at this point either manually reboots each lift sequentially, or can configure a script to do this for them. Now to show you an actual demonstration of ISSU. Here with me today, I have several different devices. Off screen, I've got two PCs. One of them is acting as a video server, so this is going to be the device here. And I've also got another device acting as a client. Connected to these both are two edge switches. What I've got here is X510s, and then both of these connect to two X8106 chassis, which are configured as a VC stack plus stack. Now within this, the stack is considered a virtual switch. So both these X510s have an LACP link connecting to each stack member. This means that one chassis can go down completely and the video will continue to function. But what I'm here to show you today is ISSU being upgraded on these devices. And through using the video, we'll see that just how resilient the chassis actually is. And so now let's actually do the ISSU itself. So now to flick you over to my laptop here. Before I do that, I'll just turn on both these screens so that you can actually see the video that we've got going on. This one's just taking its time. There we go. Okay, cool. Now to show you on my screen, I've got, here we go. So I'll do the command show stack, and we can see that we've got our four controller cards. And we can, what we should also do is just check the version of software that we're actually running. And as you can see here, I'm running version 5.4.4-1.1. Now, what I hadn't already mentioned is that I've already put the new software version that I want to upgrade to on our chassis master, or active CFC, and we can check this in the flash. And as you can see here, I've got version 1.2, which is the one that we want to upgrade to. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is actually do the ISSU command itself. It's really simple. It's just one command, as you can see here. And I'm just going to copy on the build itself and kick it off. Now we can see we've got a few warning messages. So what it's just telling us is that it's upgrading the preferred release to the new one. The CFCs will then be rebooted one at a time. And to complete ISSU, you'd need to manually reboot the line cards, or we can do them using a script. So let's actually just kick that off now. Okay, so the first thing that's going to happen is it's going to sync the new software version to the other stack members or the other controller cards, because it's currently only on stack master. And now we're seeing that card 2.6 is left, so this is the last stack member or the last controller card in our stack. We can see this when we do show stack, and that card is currently being booted. Now, one thing I haven't mentioned is that we are also going to be speeding the video up just so then we can save you time with watching it. I'm still going to stand here the whole time and video is going to keep playing, but we're just going to cut to the important parts along the way. Okay, so as we could see just there, the card 2.6 just finished syncing and now 2.5 is being rebooted. And as we can see here, it's telling us that it's due to ISSU. A couple of things to also point out to you, you can also do show ISSU, and this will give you a bit of information about where ISSU is at. So we can see here that card 2.6 is already upgraded, meanwhile card 2.5 is currently being upgraded, and then we've got 1.6 and 1.5 left to do. We can also see that how long ISSU is actually been running. So we can see here that it's been running for just over 4 minutes. And another important command to show you is that you can also check which versions each of your lifts or controller cards are running. And so you can do show card to show you that, or show card detail, I should say. Now within this command here, we can see a few different things going on. So we can see the line card itself and the software version that it is running, along with its MAC address and bootloader version. So I mentioned show card just before instead of show card detail, but show card is also quite important itself and quite useful, because we can see here which devices are currently being upgraded by ISSU. Once ISSU has actually finished upgrading the CFCs, we'll actually get a little star beside the line cards to show that those are now actually running a different version. Okay, so card 2.5 has just joined the stack again. Now we're going to have to be waiting maybe a couple minutes just for it to finish syncing. Okay, cool. So we've just seen that card 1.6 is now being rebooted. So card 2.6 has just finished doing ISSU, and now we've moved over to our first chassis, chassis number one. So now to wait for that card to rejoin. Actually, to just cut from there, I've just moved the console cable from card 1.5 to card 1.6, and the reason I did this is because this CFC is about to reboot and we don't really want to see the whole boot up process of it, just so then we can actually see what's going on with the rest of the chassis or the rest of the stack. Actually, this is a good time to point out another thing. So when ISSU is active or it's in progress, what we can see here is when a user logs in, either from SSH or Telnet or just from the console itself, there is an ISSU warning message. And so we can see that this here, so it just says ISSU is active, changes to the configuration are currently blocked. So for example, I can't just go config T and then interface port 1.1.1. Please wait for ISSU to complete. I should also point out there are a couple other commands to see what's going on. So there's show system. So this is a pretty common command. Oh, there goes that last controller card being upgraded. So we've just had we've just had a stack or master failover. So this is where one of the other controller cards has taken over as the active CFC. And I don't think I saw anything go wrong there. I don't think there was a single glitch on here. There might have been, but I didn't see it. Could have just been for a split second, but the point here is just how resilient this actually is. We didn't see anything that took the network down. Our networks continue to function, which is the whole point of ISSU in the first place. So to get back to what I was saying, I'll just log in again and we'll just have a look at show system, which here we can see everything about our systems really. So we've got our first stack member with its two CFC960 controller cards, and then we've got one line card in each of our chassis. But the thing I wanted to point out to you is this warning down here. So it says, warning, ISSU is currently in progress. System may be running with a different software version. So there's that one. There's also show version, which if I just scroll back up, we can see the software release, which the active CFC has taken over and running. And it's got a little star just here to point out that ISSU is in progress. And we can run that command I mentioned earlier, show card detail, which will give us more information about which devices are running which software version. So we're just waiting for that last controller card to finish booting up and finish syncing. So we'll be back in just a minute. Right, so ISSU has just finished, well, sorry, that CFC has just finished syncing to the chassis, and we've now just had all our controller cards rejoin the chassis running the new version of software. At this point in time, our line cards are still running an old release, but the important thing here is that our CFCs are now running this new software version without any overall downtime. So we'll just have a look at where the chassis currently is, or the state that it's in. And we can just do show card, and we can see what I mentioned earlier, which is the line cards now have a little star beside them saying that they're running a different version of software to the active CFC, and these line cards need to be rebooted. Another point to make is that the chassis will still function fine with these line cards running in a different software release, but it is advisable that you do reboot your line cards to get to the new version of software. This could be, you know, down to maybe the reason that you upgraded, maybe it's to get some new features, or possibly it's to fix a bug or something like that. But the important thing is what we're going to do now is just go and reboot each of these line cards. We're going to do a gap between them, so the video is going to keep flowing as they're being rebooted. So I'll go ahead and reboot the first line card now. So I'll just do reboot card 1.1. And again, we're still not seeing any artifacts or video, or the video glitching or anything like that. Again, proving just how resilient this network actually is, giving you faith that it's actually going to keep working fine when you're upgrading your software. And a thing to point out is that the line cards, they're not going to take as long as the CFCs. It should be roughly maybe around a minute per X1. Obviously this can come down to how much config you have applied, as it's got to do config replay, but it doesn't take that long for each line card to come back. And we can check its progress. Well, I mean, it gives us messages on the console here, but we can also check the progress in show card. We can see that the card 1.1 is currently in a state of being configured. And now configuration is actually completed, as you can see here. So now I'm going to go ahead and reboot card 2.1, which will then complete ISSU overall. And again, we can, oh no, just a little glitch there. That was just LACP failing over that link. But now we can see on the console that ISSU has successfully completed. So this is another point to make. ISSU considers itself complete once that last device has been kicked off to reboot. Because in ISSU's point of view, everything has been upgraded. The line cards are now set to boot that new version of software. So we can still wait for that card to come back. But the important thing here is that ISSU has been resilient that whole time. Our chassis haven't gone down. There haven't been any massive crashes. We've already got resiliency using this virtual switch, or the stack acting as a virtual switch. And so ISSU is a really reliable feature within the X8100 series of switches. So, and as I look down at my screen, we can see that configuration has already completed. I did notice just a little slight blip on the stream just there, but again, it's only, you know, you might not see it if you'd have to blink really, but yeah. So at the end of the day, I hope this has been really helpful. I hope you've enjoyed this presentation I've shown you, and thanks for your time.